In this video, we are going to see the factors affecting the process of photosynthesis. So there are a number of external and internal factors affecting the process of photosynthesis. As we studied in our Form 2 nutrition, that we had different internal and external factors affecting photosynthesis. But here in the advanced nutrition, first thing we need to know or to understand is about the concept of limiting factor before we are going to discuss about the different factor affecting photosynthesis. So what is the limiting factor? Kwa ufupi ni kwamba limiting factor ni ile factor ambayo ukibadilisha ndio ita affect process yetu kwa urahisi. Kwa hiyo wanasayansi mwanzoni walikuwa wanataka kuangalia kitu kinachoitwa minimum, optimum na maximum value. Kwa hiyo hizo minimum, optimum na maximum value zinaitwa cardinal points of individual factor, without realizing the importance of simultaneous effect of other factor upon the rate of release. Kwa hiyo wanasayansi wataka waangalie, je, tukichukua light peke yake tukaiweka minimum, optimum light na maximum, cardinal point za light zinakuwaje? Wakataka tuangalie tukichukua temperature peke yake zitakuwaje? Hawakutaka kuangalia tukicombine factor mbili au tatu kwa pamoja. So the minimum of a factor is that value below which the physiological process cannot occur. Maximum of a factor is that value beyond it the physiological process comes to stop. And the optimum value of a factor is that point where the physiological process continues indefinitely at highest velocity. Kwa minimum ni pale ambapo chini yake process iendelee. Maximum ni pale ambapo juu yake process iendelee. Na optimum ni pale ambapo physiological process inakwenda continue very fast. But the area workers failed to assign the absolute value for the factors because it is not possible to treat the factor affecting the rate of photosynthesis individually. The factor have to be treated in relation to the other. Kwa walishindwa kutreat factor affecting photosynthesis. Kwa nini? Kwa sababu watu wetu kamtreat factor moja moja. Tunaweza tukatreat factor kwenye uhusiano au in relation to other factors. Kwa hii ndio grafu ambayo walichora hapo. Kama unavyoweza kuona kwenye minimum ndio hapa, beyond which no process can occur. Hapa ndio optimum na hapa ndio maximum. So in the optimum hapa ndio pana maximum rate. So here is the rate of photosynthesis and here is the factor affecting photosynthesis. So now kumbe ulichokuja kugundua ni kwamba unatakiwa uwe unajua kivipi factor mbalimbali zinaingiliana ku affect photosynthesis. So the rate of biochemical process like photosynthesis, which involve a series of reaction, the rate of biochemical process, which I did this word, the rate of biochemical process like photosynthesis, which involve a series of reaction, will generally be limited by the slowest reaction in the series. Kwa hii ndio sentence ya mwisho kuja nayo kwamba okay, rate ya photosynthesis, biochemical reaction kama photosynthesis ambayo ina step nyingi itakuwa affected na slowest reaction. For example, in photosynthesis, the light independent reaction are dependent on light dependent reaction for releasing ADP and ATP. Kwenye photosynthesis, reaction ambazo zinaitwa dark reaction au light independent, yani hazitegemei kwenye mwanga, zenyewe zinategemea product kutoka kwenye light independent, kama zinategemea ADP na ATP. At low light intensity, the rate at which these are produced is too slow to allow light independent reaction to proceed at maximum rate. Kwa utagundua kwamba katika mazingira ambayo tunakuwa tuna small light intensity, the ADP and ATP produced are very small, so the light independent reaction cannot proceed. So what can we say about this? Hapa ndipo ambapo tunakuja kusema kwamba light is the limiting factor. So we have the principle of the limiting factor here, and you can state it as: when a chemical process is affected by more than one factor, its rate is limited by that factor which is nearest its minimum value. It is that factor which directly affect a process if its quantity is changed. Kwa hiyo in the principle limiting factor, some of the teacher they may ask you to state it in the exam kwamba when a chemical process is affected by more than one factor, kama chemical process inakuwa affected na factor nyingi, then rate yake itakuwa limited na ile factor ambayo iko kidogo, nearest its minimum value. Or in other words, you can state at any given moment, the value of physiological process is limited by, the rate of physiological process is limited by factor which is in shortest supply, and by that factor alone. That is to say that factor which is in nearest its minimum value is the one which determines the rate of reaction. Any change in the level of this factor, called limiting factor, will affect the rate of reaction. Change in the level of other factor has no effect. Kwa kama light ikiwa limiting factor, hata ukiongeza carbon dioxide, hai affect photosynthesis hata kidogo. Mpaka uchange light. The principle was first established by Blackman in 1905. Since then, it has been shown that different factors such as carbon dioxide, concentration, the light intensity interact and can be linked at the same time, although one is often the major factor. So consider one of these factors, which is light intensity. Now here you just consider one of the factor which is light intensity, and you want to know how the light intensity affects the process of photosynthesis, or how the light intensity can become limiting factor. Photosynthesis cannot proceed in dark because the absence of light limits the process. Kwa hiyo kama kwenye giza kabisa photosynthesis haiwezi kuendelea, manake the supply of light will alter the rate of photosynthesis. Unapokuwa unaweka mwanga, unakuwa unabadilisha speed ya photosynthesis. Now more light, more photosynthesis, au kwa lugha nyingine, increase in light intensity have a linear relationship with increase in the rate of photosynthesis. So for example, in this graph, in part A, light was the limiting factor for photosynthesis. So the increase in light intensity increased the rate of photosynthesis. The light intensity directly proportional to the rate of photosynthesis here in part A. But in part B, other factor, they have started to become limiting factor in part B. In part C, light is no longer a limiting factor. So increase in light intensity does not affect the rate of photosynthesis. Why? Because light is no longer the limiting factor. Other factors has become the limiting factor here in part C. So as you can see in my explanations of the graph, that increase in light intensity have linear relationship with the increase in light in part A of the graph. If, however, more carbon dioxide or higher temperature is applied to a plant in dark, there will be no change in its level. In dark, there will be no change in the rate of photosynthesis. Light is the limiting factor. Therefore, only a change in its level can affect the rate of photosynthesis in part A. If amount of light given to a plant is increased, the rate of photosynthesis increased up to a point and then tails off. At point D here, light is no longer the limiting factor. From point D, light is no longer the limiting factor, and the appearance of the graph changes to horizontal. So this is an example of how the light can act as light is a limiting factor. At this point, some other factors such as concentration of carbon dioxide is in short supply, and so limited the light. An increase in carbon dioxide concentration again increases the amount of photosynthesis until some other factors such as temperature limit the process. So this is also the graph which show how the temperature and the carbon dioxide can limit the process of photosynthesis. So as you can see here, here photosynthesis is limited by carbon dioxide. In this part, increase in carbon dioxide increases the rate of photosynthesis. But here photosynthesis is limited by temperature. Low concentration of carbon dioxide, low temperature. High concentration of carbon dioxide, low temperature. Because you have increased the concentration of carbon dioxide, means the tearing off of the graph is because of temperature. And then the higher concentration of carbon dioxide, higher temperature. Here photosynthesis is limited by some other factors, not temperature, not carbon dioxide concentration. So That's all about the concept of limiting factor. And as you can see, this graph, this is the one which was in the notes above, and then they want you to study the graph and answer the question that follow. This question is present in the biological science book, and its answers there. So that's the end of the lecture explaining about the concept of limiting factor. And in the next lecture, we shall be discussing about the factors affecting the process of photosynthesis, and we will be discussing internal and external factors affecting the process of photosynthesis. Subscribe to the channel and share the link to your fellows, so as you can share these materials about plant nutrition. Don't forget to click the link below to join my Telegram group for more discussions and updates. Thank you, everybody.